has been such a fabulous show. It is so good to be here. This is what it is all about, ladies and gentlemen. The community working together, honoring each other, respecting each other, and drinking together, ladies and germs. It seems that we have another raffle! All right, people, now you think, oh God, they're doing another goddamn raffle. Where are the boobs? These raffles are important. Every last penny of these raffles goes to the museum, and it goes to the Legends Challenge, and all of that business, all this little money goes to making all this happen. So I would like to reintroduce this raffle in a proper manner with your proper support. So here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, I think it's time for a raffle! And here is the lovely Kingfish to make this raffle happen.
And I'm here, ladies and gentlemen, to bring out to the stage right now from your Burlesque Hall of Fame executive team, Desiree DeMore! Woo!
Thank you, Kingfish.
Yay! Do you need help?
Getting this dress off you? Yes. How do we do this?
What are you doing? What are you doing? Good God.
Okay, I'll let it go.
There we go. I'm saving that. That's like a whole nother thing.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I would just really like to start by thanking you as the financial director and a board member of the Burlesque Hall of Fame. It's just like Foxy said, every dollar that you put into raffles, that you put into classes, that you put into Legends Challenges, they all go to either the Legends or the museum. So thank you so much for all that you do. We really appreciate it. And with... You all make this happen. We just walk around looking glamorous. So Megan Doss is going to be the official raffle gold spinny thing spinner, as well as the red tickety ticket taker. Now, when we pick a winner, please do not come up to the stage. Please do meet me out in the lobby right after the show, and we will have your raffle bags for you. So without further ado, the first place big fancy raffle bag, which will include a beautiful rhinestone clutch from Coca Fashions, as well as an awesome set of pasties from Hardcore Pasties. And that's Foxy's company, so you know they're hardcore. As well as a beautiful pinup bathing suit from Queen of Hearts. The lucky winner of all those things and more is number
38371.
Are you here? 383717? Unfortunately, you can win without being here, but they obviously didn't win since they didn't see Dita or Catherine. Okay, the next bag, which includes a beautiful romper from Queen of Hearts, as well as many fine prizes, is going to raffle number
383663.
Where the fuck are these people at? I'm gonna take it all home if one of you ain't here. Okay, next. Oh, Alan. I just have to give it up to Alan. He always wins the raffle because he always buys a shitload of tickets. This is the way to do it, people. You buy a stack like that, you're gonna win. And you can make pasties out of these. Just spread them in a fan and... Oops, we lost some. Oops.
Back in.
Let's stick those back in. Oops. If you want to donate a new raffle bin, you can. And the final winner is...
You know this part. 383 9 8-1.
Anyone? Do we have a winner out there? Stand up and show yourself. Congratulations. I don't think the pin-up denim shorts are gonna fit you, but you and I can talk afterwards, and I'll give you a pair of my husband's shorts, and I'll take yours. Thank you so much, Megan. Megan was the wonderful woman who sold you all those. She does a great job every year, as do all of our assistants. At this time, I would like to introduce someone who's very special to me as not only a friend, but as the executive director of the Burlesque Hall of Fame. It is a often thankless and a very intense job to do. And this gentleman took over about a year and a half ago, and he is definitely leading the charge that all of us are following behind to improve the museum, the weekender, and the whole burlesque experience revolving around the museum. So I'd like you all to give him a huge, warm welcome. Let me get this in the thing first. I was told I should lick it to make it easier to slide in, but ugh. I'm not licking that thing. Please give it up for the executive director of the Burlesque Hall of Fame in Las Vegas, Nevada, Dustin Wax.
Thank you. I want to welcome you all to the 56th Annual Striptease Reunion, the 23rd Annual Miss Exotic World, and the Burlesque Hall of Fame Weekender in general. I also have cards because, unlike everyone else here, I'm not really a performer. And then Dita already used all my good card jokes. So, and her cards were bigger than mine. I already used this one. I'd like to start by asking all the production team members who are out in the audience if there are any to stand up. And I can't see anything, so I'm just gonna assume you are doing that. Thank you. Look at these people. For less than the cost of a single cup of coffee every month, you can make a real difference in these people's lives. Your contribution will help us provide the schooling and resources that they need to keep them off the these people are just some of the dozens of volunteers involved in making the Weekender happen. There are over 36 people who worked hours, many of them dozens or even hundreds of hours, to bring us all together this weekend. And there's many more that are backstage or out front or not even here in town. And they gave their time, their talent, out of love for the Burlesque Hall of Fame, and love for the community, and love for burlesque. If you see them at the after party or around the hotel, take a moment to thank them, give them a massage, or a child, if they want one. I mean, whatever they want, right? Because their efforts have created not just an amazing event, but they support our work of preserving the heritage and legacy of burlesque. The Burlesque Hall of Fame exists because of people like them and people like you who contribute their time, their ideas, emotional support, their labor, and yes, their money to make sure that the unfolding history of burlesque continues to have a home. The people who are involved in this production join literally hundreds of other volunteers and donors who provide their resources that we need to grow and thrive as an organization. And you can join them in helping us to protect this legacy in so many ways. You can become a member, you can donate, obviously, and we like that a lot. You can join next year's production team. We need, you know, many, many, many people to do this job and to make this happen this whole weekend. You can spread the word about the Burlesque Hall of Fame and tell people why you love it and why you think it's important. And you can volunteer. We need designers, we need fundraisers, we need event planners, we need media people, we need project managers, we need writers, we need programmers, we need researchers. Chances are, whatever your skill or interest, we can use your help. I'd like you to, you can visit us at burlesquehall.com to get in touch, or you can grab me, or you can grab anyone you see wearing, I'm sorry, it's put in my pocket, wearing a lanyard like this, or any of the people that you saw standing up a moment ago, and they'll fill you in and they'll connect us, connect you with us. Before I get off the stage and return you to our amazing burlesque show that is just blowing my mind tonight, I do want to take a moment to recognize our fallen comrade in arms. The rest of you in the community know Sparkly Devil as a performer and as a larger-than-life character on the burlesque scene. But I know her first and foremost as the founding member of the museum's advisory council and as the creator of the Legends Challenge, which raises the money that brings so many burlesque legends to this event every year. That's how I've interacted with her for the last 18 months. Except on this stage, I don't think I've ever seen her perform. She's been a crucial part of BHUF, and she's been a personal, tremendous personal help to me as I've moved into trying to take on the role of directing this museum. So there's not a lot I can say after the lovely tributes that we had on Thursday. I just want to say that her passing last week left a tremendous hole in our organization as well as in our hearts, and that she will be missed. Thank you again for being part of the BHUF Weekender and for all that every single one of you does to keep burlesque and the Burlesque Hall of Fame alive and kicking. And we literally could not do this without every single one of you. And now let's see some burlesque. Thank you.